In this video, we're going to be looking at binomial expansion using combination. This video will be based on the principle of algebraic expression. And also the principle of permutation and combination. So with little or no knowledge of these two terms, you can still follow along with this tutorial. So let's try to recall some principles from algebraic expression. So recall from algebraic expression that if you have an expression such as 1 plus 2x squared and we have to expand this. So very simply, this can be expanded just by opening the two brackets. And since we are squaring them, we can just separate the two brackets by having 1 plus 2x and also 1 plus 2x. And this can be multiplied using the normal algebraic processes. So here, we are going to have 1 to multiply 1. Again, we are going to have 1 again to multiply 2x. And also, we are going to have 2x to multiply 1 and 2x to multiply 2x. So following that, we are going to have this to be 1 plus 2x plus 2x plus 4x squared. And adding this up, I have 1 plus 4x plus 4x squared. So with this simple opening brackets in algebraic expression, we're able to expand the expression 1 plus 2x squared. So it now gets more challenging if you have a situation whereby you have to expand the expression 1 plus 2x to the power of 8. I'm sure it won't be easy to start writing this out one after the other, 1 plus 2, 8, 2x, 1 plus 2x, up to the 8, 1 plus 2x. So in this case, we now use the concept of binomial expansion. So in this case, we are going to be following the principle of binomial expansion, and that's what we are going to be looking at basically in this tutorial. Also, we are going to be basing this tutorial, as I mentioned, on principle of permutation and combination. So again, let me do a quick recall on the principle of combination. So combination is about selection. So therefore, if you are to select 3 things from 5 things, we basically have options 5 combination 3. So we are trying to select 3 from 5. And how do we represent this in mathematics? So this is simply 5 factorial over 5 minus 3 factorial 3 factorial. So to generalize this, whenever we have n combination r, so this is going to be n factorial over n minus r factorial r factorial. And in furthering on expanding this, so we know that if you have factorial, it's simply n multiplied by n minus 1 multiplied by n minus 2 all the way to n minus r plus 1 and lastly n minus r factorial. And at the denominator we have n minus r factorial r factorial. So we're going to have this to cancel out, and finally we're going to have this to be n minus 1 n minus 2 to n minus r plus 1 over r factorial. So what this is trying to explain is basically what I already showed up here, where we have 5 combination 3. So again, just to relax the sample on this, if you have 8 combination 6, so this can be written as 8 factorial over 8 minus 6 factorial and 6 factorial, just like we have here. So this is going to be 8 factorial over 2 factorial and 6 factorial. So in simplifying this, there's no need of trying to expand 8 factorial and also 6 factorial. We can just expand 8 factorial until we reach the point of 6 factorial. So this is going to be 8 multiplied by 7 multiplied by 6 factorial all over 2 factorial multiplied by 6 factorial. So we know that 6 factorial will surely cancel out 6 factorial. So here we are now left with 8 multiplied by 7 divided by 2. and with this we can find the answer to 8 combination 6. So we are going to be basing on these two principles, the principle of binomial algebraic expression and also the principle of combination. The first example, we are to use binomial theorem to expand the term 1 plus 2x to the power of 5. In binomial expansion, one of the fastest approach is to try and simplify the expression so that 1 is the first term. In this case, we already have 1 as the first term. In some examples, you might not have 1 as the first term. What we have to do there first is to factorize the expression to make sure that we have 1 as the first term. So having 1 as the first term, we can now follow this principle to find the expansion of 1 plus 2x. So we are going to have 1 to the power of 5. And here, this can be left as only 1 because 1 to the power of 5 is still 1. So plus 5 combination 1. And then since we already simplified this to have 1 at the first term, so we can just bring in 2x 1. So take note, what is simply happening here is that if you are taking 5 combination 1, you are going to be raising the expression to the power of 1. Again, if you have 5 combination 2, and you're going to be going from 1 or to 5. So 2x to the power of 2 plus 5 combination 3. Again, 2x to the power of 3 plus 5 combination 4. 2x to the power of 4. And lastly, 5 combination 5. 2x to the power of 5. So take note here, we're going from 1 to 5. There are different methods of solving binomial expansion. Some might have to start with 0, but in this case, make sure you are starting with 1 while using the method of combination. So in previous example, I already looked at how to expand combination. So in this case, if you have 5 combination 1, this is going to be 5 factorial all over 4 factorial multiplied by 1 factorial. So this is 1 plus 5 combination 1 is simply 5 factorial over 4 factorial 1 factorial. So multiplied by 2. X plus 5 combination 2, here we are going to have 5 factorial over 2 factorial 3 factorial multiplied by 4 x squared, and here this is 5 factorial over 3 factorial 2 factorial multiplied by 8 x to the power of 3 plus 5 factorial over 4 factorial 1 factorial 16x to the power of 4, and lastly we have 5 factorial over 0 factorial 5 factorial 32x to the power of 5. So now if we expand this, we are going to have our final answer for this binomial expansion. So this is going to be 1 plus 5 factorial over 4 factorial, everything is going to be 5, so we are going to have 5 multiplied by 2, which is 10x. Plus, if we simplify this and multiply this by 4, I'm going to have this to be 40x squared. Plus, again, simplifying this, this is going to be 80x cubed. Plus, again, this expression is going to be 5 factorial. This is going to be 500 by 16, and that is 80x to the power of 4. Plus, so 0 factorial is 1. So here we're going to have 5 factorial over 5 factorial, and that is simply 1. So plus 1 times 32, which is 32x to the power of 5. So as final answer, we're going to have the expansion of 1 plus 2x to the power of 5 to be equal to 1 plus 10x plus 40x squared plus 80x cubed plus 80x to the power of 4 plus 32x to the power of 5. And then you have the expansion of 1 plus 2x to the power of 5. So take note, as I mentioned, most of time it will be easier for you to make 1 to be the first term. So in case we have any other thing other than 1 in the first term, we simply have to factorize and have our expression written in this form. In next example, we're going to be looking at a different approach to binomial expansion using. So the second example, we are to obtain the first 4 terms of the expansion of 2 plus 1 over 2x to the power of 8 in ascending power of x. You see from here that we are not to express the expansion of the whole term, but the first 4 terms of the expansion. And if you check, the first 4 term, since we are always starting from 1, So it's going to be 1 plus something to the power of 1 plus another coefficient to the power of 2 plus another coefficient to the power of 3. So even though we are looking for the first four terms, we are going to stop at the point where x is to the power of 3, since we have 1 or the constant as the first term. So using this, we are going to be finding the first four term of the expansion of 2 plus 1 for 2x to the power of 8. So if you check from here, you can see that the first term here is not 1, it's 2. So working with 2 might not be easy for us. So the first thing we have to do is to factorize this expression so that we can have 1 as the first term. So doing that, we are going to have this equal to 2 into brackets 1 plus 1 over 4x and everything here to the power of 8. So we have 2 plus 1 plus 1 over 4x to the power of 8. So this is also 2 to the power of 8 multiplied by 1 plus 1 over 4x to the power of 8. So now we are simplifying the binomial expansion of this term. So making 2 to the power of 8 the reference, so we are going to have this to be equal to 1 plus, just like we had in the last example. So we are simply taking the binomial expansion of this. So 1 plus 8 combination 1, 1 over 4x to the power of 1 plus 8 combination 2, 1 over 4x to the power of 2 plus 8 combination 3, 1 over 4x to the power of 3. And this proceeds on to 8 combination 8. But since we are looking for the first four terms, we are going to stop at the point where x raised to the power of 3. So this is 2 to the power of 8, 1 plus 8 factorial, all over 7 factorial, 1 factorial, multiplied by 1 over 4x, plus 8 combination 2, this is 8 factorial, over 2 factorial, 6 factorial, multiplied by 1 over 16x squared. And lastly, 8 factorial over 5 factorial, 3 factorial, multiplied by 1 over 64x to the power of 3. So the next thing is to simplify the expression. Here we are going to have this to be 2 to the power of 8. 1 plus, so this is going to be 8 factorial over 7 factorial. Here we are going to have this to be equal to 8 multiplied by 1 over 4, and that's going to be 2x plus 8 factorial, or simply 8 multiplied by 7 multiplied by 6 factorial over 2 factorial multiplied by 6 factorial multiplied by 1 over 16 x squared. So you are going to have 6 factorial to cancel out 6 factorial. And we have 8 multiplied by 7 divided by 2 factorial. And lastly, we have 8 multiplied by 7 multiplied by 6 multiplied by 5 factorial all over 5 factorial multiplied by 3 factorial. So this is all multiplied by 1 over 64 x to the power of 3. So you're going to have 5 factorial, cancel out 5 factorial. I will know that 3 factorial, which is 3 multiplied by 2, is the same thing as 6. So 3 factorial is going to cancel out 6. So finally, this is going to be 2 to the power of 8, which is simply 256. 1 plus 2x plus 8 multiplied by 7, that is 56 divided by 2, you have 28 multiplied by 1 over 16 x squared plus 8 multiplied by 7, that is 56 multiplied by 1 over 64 x cubed. So opening the bracket with 256, we are going to have this to be equal to 256 plus 256 multiplied by 2, that's 512 plus 2, if this is multiplied by 28 divided by 16, you're going to have 448. And lastly, we're going to have 256 multiplied by 56 divided by 64, which is 224. Escape. So finally, we are able to get the first four terms of the binomial expansion to be equal to 256 plus 512x plus 448 squared plus 224 escape, and this proceeds all to x to the power of 8. So that's where we can get the first nth term of a particular binomial expansion. And here we see that after having the question, we have to factorize so that we can make 1 to be the first term, and making this equation to be simpler for us to work with. So that's it, guys. That's it on how to find the binomial expansion using combination. Next tutorial, I'm going to be looking at how we can find binomial expansion using the Pascal triangle. So thank you, and see you in the next tutorial.